Hello children, in this video we are going to create and customize table of contents. Now what is table of contents? Writer's table of contents feature lets you build an automatic table of contents from the headings in your document. Before you start, make sure that the headings are styled consistently. For example, you can use the heading 1 style for the chapter titles and the heading 2 and heading 3 styles for the chapter subheadings. So table of content is like an index that you find in the front pages of your book or the index that you create in your notebooks, right? So here we are going to do it practically. See, I have taken 2 chapters from employability book, right? First chapter is stress management skill and the second is, you can see, green skills, right? So what we have to do before creating the table of contents, we have to provide styles, paragraph styles to all the headings. You can see if I'm clicking on self-management skill, heading 1 is selected, right? Because I have given heading 1 to the self-management skill. If I click on the stress, heading 2 is selected, right? And I have told you in my previous videos how you can provide styles to the text, right? What you have to do, just select the text and click on the headings on the style that you want to apply, like I'm clicking on heading 3 or heading 2, right? In this way, you have to give the styles to all the headings of your content, right? Now, next step is click on the insert menu and then click on the index and table option. And after that, again, click on the index and table options, right? So index, you will get insert index table window, right? It is having different tabs like index table, entries, styles, columns, background. One by one, I'll explain you the working of all the tabs, right? So by default, this is already selected indexing type. So in the type and title, the first is title. This is the title that you want to give to your title of contents. So here I can write employability skill because I have taken chapters from the employability skills book. Okay. Table of type, table of the content. Okay, so here I'm going to create the table of the content. So this is already selected. Fine. Okay. And create index table for entire document. Yes, I want to create it for the entire document. So I have clicked on the entire document. Fine. And evaluate up to the label. Here I want to evaluate up to the heading 2, right? Heading 1 and heading 2. I want that heading 1 and heading 2 should appear in my index, right? So I have written 2 here. Fine. Okay. Then create from. In create from, you have to select the outline checkbox. Okay. And clear the index marks. Fine. Okay. Now we have the additional styles that we will do later on. I'm just going to explain all this, then after this I'll tell you what is the use of additional style, that, right? So I'm clicking on okay. Fine, this is my contents, right? Index, this is my index, or you can say this is my table of contents. Here our table of contents has created. Now, if you want to edit the table of content, what you will have to do, right click on the table of content, right? And click on edit index table. Here again, you will get the same window, same dialog box. So we have done title, right? We have done create index table options and we also have done evaluate up to label 2. Right, now what is the use of protected against manual changes? If this is selected, right, you are not able to make changes in the table of contents. And if it is not selected, you can do it manually. You can do the change manually. I'm showing you, right? If I want to change any word, see, if I want to delete or change any word, this is not possible because this is protected against manual changes, right? So again, I'm clicking on edit index table. Okay, if I deselect this and then I click on the OK, what will happen? I can change anything that I want manually. The state of management, I can write manage. Okay, so this is the, again, okay, so I'm doing it management again. And then here, edit index and table. And I'm clicking on protect it against manual changes, right? Okay, so what is the use of additional style? If you will click on the additional styles, right, you are able to provide additional styles to your headings, right? Okay, if I want to, let us suppose I want to apply content to my heading 2, right? Okay. So in this way, you can apply this to heading 2 or you can apply this to heading 1. Okay, and then click on OK. Fine, and again click on OK. Right, so you can see there is not a big change in the headings, right? Okay, then again, click on index and table. Right, so we have done index and table tab. Fine. Now next tab is entries tab. Okay, so here I am going to tell you what are the different options which are available in the entries tab. Fine. Okay, entry tab is used to format the entries in the table of contents, right? Okay, so here you can see these labels are the heading labels, label 1, label 2. These are the heading 1, heading 2 labels, right? And see, structure and formatting. This is the structure line. The structure line displays the elements for entries in that labels, right? Each button on the structure line represents one element. E hash, you can see E hash button represents the chapter number. And this E button represents the entry text, fine. E represents the entry text. Then you have T. The T button represents a tab stop, right? Hash button represents the page number, fine. Okay, so we can also create the hyperlink of the headings, and how we will create this, I'm just going to tell you. Okay, so first, what you have to do to create the hyperlink, what you have to do, click on the blank space before E hash here and click on hyperlink, right? LS button is added. The LS button represents the start of a hyperlink, fine? It represents the start of a hyperlink. Okay, then click on the blank space before T, okay, and then click on hyperlink. Fine, LE button represents the end of a hyperlink, right? Okay, and then we have to click on okay. Fine, so you can see here your chapter names have become hyperlink. When you will click on this, control plus click, see. Fine. Again, if you are clicking on this, control click, green screens. Fine. So here we have created hyperlinks. Fine. Now, see, if you will click on all here, okay, all the content of the table will become hyperlink. So I am clicking on all. Fine. And then click on OK. You can see all the headings have become hyperlink now. So you can click on any of the heading and then reach that particular content. So all the headings have become hyperlink now. See. Okay. Again, click on edit index table. Fine. Okay. So now we have the character style. In character style, we can provide a different character style to the structure line. See, on the structure line, click the button that represents. Okay, so we can provide the character style to any of the headings by using the character style. Like I want to apply bullets, not bullets, but default character style to the heading 1 default. Okay, heading 1 ko hum character styles provide current default, and then click on the edit. Okay, from here you can change the color, background color, right, and fonts. You can provide different fonts. Algerian, I'm giving the Algerian, and then the font size 15. Okay, so click on OK, and then okay, see, we have changed the character style. Fine. Again, click on edit index and table option. Fine. Now click on the style tab. Right? Style tab is used to apply paragraph styles to the table of contents. You can apply a different paragraph style to each outline label of the table. So I have label 1, content 1. Okay, so I want to replace this with heading 1 with any style you can choose. Like I can choose from here content 1 or content 2. Fine, and then click on and this content 2, and you can also edit this. Again, we have the same effects, font style. Okay, 15 point font effects. Ready there. Yellow. Strike through and all this. So you can edit this also. Fine, and then click on OK. See, first you have to edit the style. Yellow green, color red. Fine. Font style this and this. Okay, and then content. Okay, so it has been changed, right? Fine. So here we have done the styles tab, how we can change the style of the headings, right? Fine. Then click on the column tab. From this, you can set the columns that in how many columns you want to divide your table of contents. Like if you want to divide it into two columns, click on two, okay, and then click on okay. You can see, okay. So again, I'm going to click on one, right? So this is your choice in how many columns you want to divide your table of content. Fine. Again, edit index table, background. In the background, you can give the color. Like I want to give the yellow color to the background and then click on OK. Fine. In the background, you can give either color or see. I can also give the graphics in the background. So here you have to click on the browse button and then I'm going to take any picture from this. I'm taking this background. Fine. So in the type, you can decide the position. See, in the center or in the corner. Fine. So in this way, you can decide the position of the picture. Okay. Area means it will cover the whole area, and tiles, it means the picture will come in the form of tiles until it will cover the whole index of content, right? So I'm clicking on position. This is occupying the center position. Then click on OK. So you can see the picture in the background. Fine. And if you want to remove the color as well as the picture, then click on the no fill and then click on OK. Fine. Okay. See. Okay. If you do any change in the table of the content, like if I'm making it these are heading one and heading two, right? If I'm making it the heading three, which is not included, stress causal agents, right? This is, I'm making it heading three, right? But still this is present in my table of content, right? Okay, so what you have to do, if you are doing any change, then you should update your content, right? Index, you should update your index. So for this, how you can update your index, right click and then click on update index table. You can see now it is not available here because I have included only two headings in my table of content in my index, right? Fine. So this is the way how you can update your index table. Fine. So in this way you can create your table of contents.